Welcome here. We're super excited. You would not believe the buzz going on a half an hour ago, even an hour ago. So we're taking deep breaths to just bring the energy down. We are so excited to have you here tonight. And this is the first musical that's been done at Fairbairn. So we are thrilled that you are here. And also we have mostly kids here running things today. In the day, we're privileged to have class time to rehearse and practice whether our acting, our backstage. And so you'll see kids busy at work. A few adults have stepped in tonight to make sure it all goes smoothly, but mostly, I say 90% is kids running this. So they are super pumped, I'm super pumped. I just wanna give a special welcome to Allison Purcell. Are you here? Oh, in the back. One of our trustees came tonight, so thank you for coming and supporting us here at Fairbairn. And cell phones off, or just your sound off, you're welcome to take pictures, and then after, while the afters come out, you can take pictures of them there tonight. So, all right, enjoy the show.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh, Thank you. you're expecting in any minute.
Do you really live here? Or is this a train station?
We really live here. Now, everyone, would you all come here, please? Quickly, everyone. Mrs. Annie, the orphan who will be staying with us for Christmas. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear. Now, what do you want to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first. Then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you're a guest. You won't have to do any cleaning here. And for the next few weeks, you won't have a swell time. Now.
Come on, slow folks. Gotta get to Roxy before the prices change. to my seat. The shimmer of my square, the pulse,
the beat,
the rise. You must think I swear, but wow, I come alive.
The scene is bright, as the day I came, it blinks, it just erased.
To think that I've lived here all my life and never seen these things.
And why see?
Hey, fair, how we strive for 3 or 4 bucks.
while she yet warm looks.
The little brat, it ain't fair, this here life is dropping me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat. Maybe she hopes to be that little late to getting more bucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give you one guess.
Yes!
Listen in, all right? Be now there.
Cooper Lily. It's nice to be here.
I hear you've got something very important to tell the folks at home about little Annie here.
Yes, sir, I do. I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. And I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
Wow! So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of the station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks, and I do hope you don't attract every scam from coast-to-coast.
So do I, personally, so do I.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another one of our Thursday night get-togethers have gone by faster than you could say Austin. Yes, this is your second favorite radio host, Pearl Healy, saying until next week, same time, same station. Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Well, the sparrow?
I'm sorry, Addie. I've spoken to more than 1,000 different people claiming to be your parents, but they were all liars and fakes.
Aw, gee.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Grace?
Yes, sir?
Do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
And I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Aww.
Annie, this is going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. You can have anyone in the world you have come to. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell here, and Drake, and Miss Pugh, and, well, everyone here.
Drake?
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir. Have to go to look at.
Can you go, Annie?
Oh, and the kids!
Oh, Annie, I'm afraid it'll be far past our bedtime now. But I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone here from the orphanage tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid!
Together at last, together forever, we're tied in a knot, they never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies. I don't need anything but you.
Yesterday was plain awful.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was plain awful.
But that's not now. Let's end.
I'll
raise you in my eyes. But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I will not go sailing with you, I don't need
anything.
I don't need anything but you.
We must celebrate, because we just heard the most wonderful news in the world. Annie is father, mother, and all. I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge. Annie!
I've lost my Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling I've seen that Mr. Mudge before, and he's not who he says he is.
Then you won't give up the tour, sir.
But how?
I'll find a way. I'll go to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he's a Democrat.
$50,000 certified. Depends on the order of. Jig is up.
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, known as...
Mr. Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dick.
I believe you find this woman their accomplice.
I've never seen these people till yesterday. Annie, tell them how good I've always been to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but I remember one thing you always taught me. Never tell a lie.
Rat.
Miss Hannigan's gone for good!
Yay!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Tomorrow, get your $1,000 out tomorrow.
There'll be sun just thinking about tomorrow. Is a way to cobwebs and sorrow. Till there's one for the day that's gray and lonely. I'm sick of my chin and grin.
One of the orphans carrying out the flowers. Thanks, Mary.
All right, I just want to thank everyone for coming out. If you made both shows, that's super. If you made one show, that's fantastic. We had a double cast, as I'm sure you realized, and we had two directors. Mrs. Heth was the director of this show, and Mr. Miller in the back. He's just can't get enough of this place, but he's here back again tonight. Congratulations to both of them on fantastic shows. And thanks to both cast. I also want to thank, if you came and you were at rehearsals or you came to pick up the kids, you saw consistently the same staff here every night. And so you know who they are. I don't want to miss anyone, but Miss Johnson, Miss Martins, Mr. Miller, Mr. Connick, Mr. Barnett, and Mrs. Pinto's here, as well as Mr. Hamilton, who used his handiwork and built this stage with his two bare hands, and Miss Virtual is here quite often too. So thanks to you guys.
And the principal who allowed us to do this, because we, when the restrictions lifted, like I put my little note, I said, could we maybe try this? He's like, you go for it, you got all my support, so thank you for that.
I'm really glad you could put this off, and I think you realized with the intense rehearsal schedule we had, things had to come together quite quickly, and it couldn't have done any better underneath anyone else's care other than Mrs. Heth and Mr. Miller, but a little poke of our appreciation. And Mrs. Heth is finishing up on our staff this year. She's heading off to Patterson next year, but I don't think you've seen the last of her here, so I have a really good feeling about that. And so thanks to everyone, and thanks for your kids, and hopefully they get some sleep. We have exams coming up, but we had to squeeze this in first. So thanks everyone, and thanks for coming.